Is it okay to start? Okay. Well, my name is Yoshi. I'm fourth generation sushi chef. And today, I want to introduce the Japanese cuisine technique and also vegetable sushi. Today's a little bit short time, so I already prepared some Japanese vegetable sushi material. Okay. This is the tomato, looks good, looks tuna. And this is the eggplant we fried. And this is the paprika, and we fried too. We boiled small asparagus. And this is a kampyo, which is just skin of some plants. And we boiled, but it's very traditional Japanese sushi material. Well, I think many almost Japanese people knows kampyo. Well, even Japanese people, we enjoy the vegetable sushi, actually. This is called menegi, it's a kind of small plant. But before we cook, I want to introduce Japanese cuisine. This is my restaurant, established 1910, about 110 years ago. Actually, my restaurant is very old Japanese wood house, like a Japanese small house. And also, we produce just sushi. That is quite interesting because if you find a Japanese restaurant in all over the world, in overseas, some Japanese restaurant served sushi, tempura, unagi, soba, katsu, ramen, everything. But if you visit Japan to visit some restaurant, each restaurant has a special rice. So my restaurant eats sushi special rice. So we serve only sushi. On the same time, we served some entertainment, like a geisha dancing. So guests enjoy eating sushi and watching geisha dancing. And actually, sushi counter is a collection of place of Japanese cultures. Everyone focuses on the only food, but actually Japanese cuisine thinking about other ingredients, dishes, atmospheres, knives, and each product. Everything has a great story. Each Japanese knife has a different purpose. This is for cutting fish, and this is for cutting sashimi, and also this is for cutting vegetable. Actually, we use a different knife for what I'm gonna cut. And also rice is very important for Japanese cuisine. Now we pay the tax, but old time in Japan, we pay the rice. That is quite an interesting history. So it's sushi rice. And sushi rice is not just white rice. We mix up some vinegar. And can you see the vinegar on the plate? That is not just white vinegar. Because usually vinegar made by rice. So white vinegar is very popular. But this one is made by sake remained. So that's why it's getting dark. But it's very tasty. So traditional sushi restaurant using this vinegar to make a sushi rice. When I'm making a sushi, we're always thinking about a Japanese cuisine basic philosophy. Well, as you know, Japan has four seasons, the spring, summer, autumn, and winter. And we have a custom to enjoy each food and each season. This is a wasabi. It's a real wasabi. We use a special grinder to making wasabi, like this. So this wasabi coming from bottom of Mount Fuji, which is the highest mountain in Japan, because wasabi needs a clear water. So Mount Fuji has a lot of snow on top of mountain, and snow gonna be melting through the ground and fresh water coming out around Mount Fuji. and fresh wasabi. It is difficult to get in other countries, but many traditional sushi restaurants using fresh wasabi to make sushi. Well, in my opinion, the vegetable sushi gonna be a world standard in the future because good for health and fish has a problem to the number of fish now. I'm gonna making some tomato sushi. That is a quite unique sushi and it's a very, very popular sushi. And when I'm making sushi with vegetable, we always remove the skin. That is very important. So, because the sushi is a very simple food, just one bite in your mouth. So if we didn't remove the skin remain in your mouth. So I wanna making a smooth sushi. So we cut it tomato skin like this. It's very simple cut. Just skin we cut it like that. And we prepare the boiled water now. So we put in like this. And lowering. And now getting a skin peeled out like this. And put in the ice water because color gonna be brilliant. Then just peel out like this. Very, very easy part. This technique we called yumuki. Yu means hot water. So we put in the vegetable in the boiled water and just skin take out and take off the inside of the tomato. So we use just a thick skin. That is very important part. We prepare the sweet vinegar. So we dip in the sweet vinegar for just 10 minutes. So vinegar taste transfer to tomatoes. And actually, I told you the sushi rice using a vinegar. So actually good matching with between rice and tomatoes sushi. Okay, now next move to the eggplants. And also the even eggplants, we have to take off the remove the skin. That is very important because skin always remain in your mouth. Then we cut it like a fish. So we prepare the eggplant and also paprika. Ooh, this is actually too high. And fried technique is not just fried. Actually, the lot of moisture is in vegetable. So when I, before to fry it, actually get out moisture like this. And the sushi doesn't have oil content. So the eggplants like oil. Actually, many eggplants getting a lot of oil. So this is a good combination with sushi rice. And this is a paprika. And also we have to take off the some moisture and put in there. So what's the purpose of fried? It's just take off skin. So we don't fry it completely. We just fry about surface. Then we're gonna remove the skin of like this. The important thing is we have to remove the skin when still hot, because once getting cold, it's difficult to take off the skin like that. You don't need to catch the skin, you just push like this with kitchen paper. That is very easy plate. Then put in some refrigerator, waiting just 30 minutes or hours, because actually too hot to make a sushi just now. I got the wasabi, I got some vegetable, and also some asparagus, and maybe cutting a cucumber. So when I'm making sushi, of course, we use both hands. But once, if I catch the rice directly, rice is very sticky. So you have to wet your hand like this. So actually, I prepare some water, not just water. We mix up some vinegar and water, the same vinegar of the rice, because I want to keep the same taste. So the sushi, make a rice ball on your right hand and get a vegetable on the left hand. We put the wasabi on the vegetable, put some rice on vegetable, turn around, sandwiches, two finger covered, turn around, sandwich, two finger covered. That's it. Many people ask me how much rice in one time. That is a good question. Actually, rice size is different each person's. You know, young boy coming by restaurant, I think my maker sushi is big. But old lady come to my restaurant, I adjust the small size. Connection is very important, vegetable and rice. So soft vegetable is easy to making sushi, but sometimes we have hard vegetable like asparagus and cucumber. So at that time, we're gonna using seaweed. Making a rice ball on your right hand and get a hard vegetable on the left hand, put the wasabi on it and put the rice on it. A little bit push and stable, turn over using a seaweed to fasten the vegetable like this. That's it. Oh, thank you very much. ありがとうございます。